Welcome to the 29th Winter Universiade, which continues in the Siberian city of Krasnoyarsk. And in particular, the venue being the Biathlon Academy Complex. It's a very warm welcome as the men's and women's sprint competition is on the schedule today. The men, due to start very soon, have already gone through the rifle check, and we're having a look at some of those names that maybe will feature a little bit later on. The rifle check, of course, it just covers the serial number, the magazine, the trigger pressure. They do those usual checks. From Poland, there are five competitors today, so a big contingent, not as many as the Russians, who have six. And the question is, will anyone break the Russian clean sweep, as Cote Puinel of France did yesterday in the individual event? 37 starters from 13 countries. In Krasnoyarsk at the Biathlon Academy, where the weather continues to play its part, just under freezing point. The wind direction from the southwest, but not at all strong. And we will have a look at the flags in the shooting range a little bit later on, the wind indicators. It's partly cloudy, but conditions are really very good for the 37 starters, beginning with Pavel Streba of Slovakia. They're going through the six Russian athletes, five from Norway, five from Poland, four from Korea, the Czech Republic, two from Canada, three from Belarus. It's a really good international field. From Slovakia, 20-year-old Pavel Streba from the University of Žilina. He is the first competitor away in the men's sprint. Most of these athletes competed 2 days ago in the individual. They know the course very well. They will do three laps of a 3.3 kilometer course. From the Czech Republic, a bronze medalist in the relay at the 2016 Junior World Championships, David Tolar. Third away was Viktor Kryuko, now Nikolai Gajduk. This man was the flag bearer for the Republic of Moldova at the Winter Olympic Games of 2018 in Pyeongchang. Nikolai Gajduk, the first of the splits, is at 1.4 kilometers. The man who started the race, Streba of Slovakia, has the fastest time, of course. He's the only one to go through it as yet. This man in the individual showed that he means business. Shanik, wearing number 12, he began well in the individual and was up there challenging for a medal, but faded towards the end. Maybe the shorter distance will suit him. And here is Yannick. How well does he start this time? Yesterday, very, very impressive. Coming up to the 1.4. Yannick is now. Well, I think he was really pushing it so hard yesterday, or 2 days ago in the individual, that it just affected his shooting in the last standing event. See just slight movement in the wind indicators as the first competitor arrives. Prone position, first shoot. Each miss means a visit to the penalty loop. Well, the conditions, nothing troubling him. From the Czech Republic, our first man through and clean, working his way to the top of this climb is Uldal. And you might remember we saw him leave the start in really vigorous fashion, determined. The Norwegians are determined. They need to get in here, would love to get in here and be amongst the medals. Maxim Varabay. Watching the countdown, watching the clock, listening to the buzzer as well. And he's quickly into his work. Now, Yannick. Shot cleanly through the first two rounds yesterday. And there are only two rounds today. Oh, he makes a blemish. Away in the men's sprint goes the silver medalist from the individual 2 days ago, Eduard Latipov, 25-year-old Russian. He's away as others arrive for their first shoot, the prone position, and this is Uldal. Maybe the top Norwegian hope here. One miss. Oh no, he's got a... Didn't look as though the... it looked as though maybe he'd struck the target, but it didn't register on the score. Out on the course, we can see Porshnev. And he now arrives at the first stage, the first indicator, and he has gone through quite nicely. David Tolar, who is setting an early pace, a very good early pace too. Out on the course, the athletes getting lots of encouragement, indicators of where they are in relation to the leader, basically just urging them on. Latyapov at the 2.3 is the fastest. He was number 29, but behind him will be Porshnev and Kote Punel, who we haven't seen as yet. Porshnev into the climb, which he makes look very easy. Well, and he's really closing the gap on Yannick, who of course stays a lap ahead of him. Borisnev looking superb. Wow, quick and a miss. Quick shooting, but a miss. Edward now enters this red zone. 20 odd seconds around here. Porshnev controlling his breathing, quickly into position. Rifle steady. He too cannot get through unscathed. One penalty for Porshnev. Yannick. This powerful man who just looks built to climb. Uldal's on fire. One error in the prone shoot, clean through in the standing. How well can he finish? It look as though we've got a really good contest coming up here with Poroshnev, number 31. And Yannick is behind him, although a lap ahead. And Yannick would be trying to use Poroshnev as a someone who can drag him along a wee bit. First across is David Tolar of the Czech Republic. David Tolar from the Czech Technical University in Prague. He can rest, but others have got work to do. Great sound effects. You can hear the scraping of the skis, the heavy breathing. You can see the sweat. See the energy. Hear the instructions and the encouragement as a climb this quite strenuous hill that will take them up to the 5.6 mark this time. Latyapov really skiing well, so strong. At 5.6 kilometers, Latyapov was in front. He still is. Poroshnev. Oh my word, how quick. No messing around. Confident. Wow, that might be enough. Latyapov. You'll be aware how well Ivanov shot. Can't afford to miss any more. See that clock, 34 seconds. He's got a penalty loop to take. That'll be close. But we know how strong he is going through the final leg on the skis. Has to take the wide berth. Well, this is going to be another stunning finish. Latyapov comes out of the penalty loop 6 seconds down on Ivanov, who was so clean and fast in the standing chute. Yannick just had the one blemish. There he goes, number 12. This is Uldal now. Wow, Uldal screams across. 1:10 faster. Yannick in second place. Those two had a grand battle between themselves. Just a sort of personal race. This last climb, Latyapov. But none of those who have finished yet will feel comfortable, because they know that out on the course, the big guns are in operation. 8 kilometer mark, Poroshnev. Where does he find his strength and energy from? Well, we know where he gets his energy. He trains for it. And his strength and the power and determination. Varavaya Belarus will hear and soon see Dmitry Ivanov. Ivanov, the fastest through 8 kilometres, the fastest through 8.9. He will be. Ivanov is the man with a kilometer to go, and he has someone to track all the way. Latipov looking for another medal. Will he get one? Silver 2 days ago. You don't need to be able to understand Russian to know what's being said there. It's just go faster, go faster. Fastest time was Ivanov. Now Latipov. It was fourth through the 8 kilometer mark and third through the 8.9. But the impression that's being made by Poroshnev and Latipov will make him feel really uncomfortable. Nikita Poroshnev. His aim to make it 2 golds. Well, if he doesn't make that, it'll be a surprise, because watch just how much he is extending over Prochazka as you watch. Latipov has the fastest time. Latipov still has the fastest time by 1 second. Ivanov to the line. Ivanov crosses and is in first place. Latipov. Oh, what a fantastic final leg from him. Absolutely stunning from Latipov. Two penalties. Take that into account. That's about a minute added on. Just shows what a fantastic ski he has given Poroshnev now. Whoa. He's got the downhill. He looks not quite as fluid and strong as he was in the early stages. And Latipov has just been outstanding with two penalties, and yet he's into the situation where he will grab this medal, the gold medal. Poroshnev has given it everything. He looked to have the race in the three-quarter stage because he was skiing so superbly, but maybe the effort of 2 days ago has taken its toll. They were gold and silver in the individual. They will share those same medals, but in a different order. It's been confirmed. It's Russia 1, 2, and 3 in the men's 10K sprint. It's the final act of this men's sprint on the second day of competition at the biathlon. Nikita Poroshnev, just one penalty at the range. And he receives the bronze medal. Nobody shot better today than Dmitry Ivanov. A perfect record.
Thank you.
And just 8 seconds separated him from the silver medal. A stunning ski. He might have missed two targets, but that didn't matter. He was the best on skis today, and the gold medalist, Edward Latyapov. What a race. Gripping and tense till the end. Russia, gold, silver and bronze. And there'll be more like this in the coming days from Krasnoyarsk.